Good morning, everybody. Happy Sunday. There's Shay doing her business. That's the only issue I have with a fence. At least she's not taking a big giant steamer like she did yesterday right there. All right, guys. I hope everybody had an amazing weekend so far. We did. The weather... Listen, I'm getting harassed by all the girls because I like this weather. I like football weather. I like cool weather. I like wearing jeans and boots and a hoodie. That's my style. All right, guys, let's check the bird. I already know the answer, or the egg, because now you might see it when I put you up here. We have a ring camera keeping an eye on the egg. And it's there. And we sat out here yesterday and watched the Belmont Stakes. And door knock won, baby. Door knock. That was my horse. Yeah. I didn't make any money, but I picked him and he won. He come out of the gate strong, too. And normally, if a horse does that, he comes out of the gate strong and leads in the beginning. He'll fade away towards the end. And he didn't, man. He fell back midway and then he came back in the end and won it. It was awesome. No, but we have a ring camera up there. We're getting alerts all morning. Mom and Dad have been back. But when we were out here watching the race yesterday, I didn't see a robin anywhere in sight. So I didn't know if they abandoned that nest and that egg wasn't going to survive. But it's there. Come on, Shay. Come on. So let's go over here and look at some progress. We're starting to get some grass. And then I'm going to talk about... Some of you guys aren't even going to believe this shit. It's like, I try to see the best in everybody. And I'm a pretty tolerant guy. But man, I can be a dickhead if you push me too far. I can be bad. And I got real mad this past week. And I'm not going to say names out of respect. But if it gets any worse, I'm going to start calling some people out in public. And I will. Thousands of people watch this shit. So, this is what we got going on over here. I did a video yesterday morning about this topic, slightly touched on it. Our yard's done. It's been done. Rachel and Corey are doing a lot over here as far as landscaping. And it is truly, truly, truly beautiful, guys. Why do people care what people spend their money on? I don't get it. Mind your own effing business. Mind your business. And yeah, and I'm talking to you. Okay, so let's get down to the skinny. And then we'll walk around and I'll show you, you know, some of the stuff that's been done. Okay, let's go over here. Rachel got word that there's a petition going around the village to try to put a stop to what they're doing here. Who thinks they had the right and the balls to tell somebody what they can do on their property? I'm gonna tell you right now, I did a little research too. And I was told that our name's on that petition. Now, I haven't physically seen this petition. I don't know if it's an actual document or somebody's just talking, I don't know. But it ended up in the school bus garage over here. And it's going all through town. That's slander, guys. That's slander. And you better be careful and tread lightly. Tread very lightly. There's nothing going on wrong here at all. I heard something about noise, the turf. For some reason, if you put turf on your yard, it's bad. It's bad. I mean, what if they had grass here? Does that make a difference? It's retarded, guys. And it's ridiculous is what it is. But yeah, if any of my friends that live in this village, if you come across this petition, take a picture of it and I want to see it. And I want to see who signed it. Shay, hold on. Come here. Get over here. Let's go get her. Come on. So I'm going to talk about for a second why this turf is here. Come on, get down. Come on. Those of you that don't know, Corey has a flag football team. Now these kids, a lot of them are from here, and there's at least one that lives like in Oneida. Now Corey will travel all over. They're at a football game today. Okay? He spends most of his free time training these kids. And that's why this is here. This is exactly why this is here. If it was just grass, would it make a difference to some people? I don't know. I just don't know. But Corey does great things with these kids. And a lot of these kids wouldn't have anything going on if it wasn't for him. I don't get it, guys. Jealousy, maybe? I don't know. Man, the sun's... I thought it was supposed to rain all day today. But it's not. But yeah, so that's what's going on. We got a problem neighbor. And... you know, bad neighbors, man, it sucks. And I've lived next to this neighbor for 20 plus years, never had an issue with them. And for some reason this year, everything's going bonkers. And I just don't get it, man. I tried to reach the olive branch over last week. Corey went over there. Corey come over. He's a hothead sometimes, and he's very protective of his friends. And he didn't know what was going on. He come in hot, and that kind of like ruined that. But anyway, guys, enough of that. But all right, let's walk around real quick, and I'm going to show you the progress, and then I'll put a video up of everything at night. I don't know where Rachel comes up with this stuff, to be honest with you. I mean, she's got a mind for, I can't visualize anything like this. And of course, the Kimball boys, Nick and Rachel together, are dangerous. They really are. Okay, so... we have sod here, and then that's all going to be sod over there. And I think she's going to go a little ways sod over there and then hydro seed everything else. But this walkway is kick ass. It's not as impressive during the day, but look at this video. I walked across our patio back over here last night. Check this out. Truly amazing, isn't it? Come on, Shay, let's go by the pond. Check out the pond. Yeah, so it's coming along over here, the fence. Their fence is going in tomorrow. Man, this gate kicks my ass, guys, every time. Now, the fence is going in tomorrow, so that's a good thing. So, one step closer to completion. And we'll get rid of this dirt and mud and dust and the noise and the people in the backyard all the time. It's almost over. Just relax. Just chill. And I talked about the noise ordinance too, because I heard noise was an issue. And our code guy said it's 80 decibels across property lines or 11 p.m. is the... you have a party, you have loud music going, a band playing or whatever, they got to be done by 11. And that is not an issue, guys. It's not an issue. So... be nice. Just be nice. That's all you got to do. If you're a cranky fuck, keep it to yourself, man. It looks bad. It looks really, really bad. Horrible, actually. So, this is what I did the other day. I went over to help my mother at her house for something. And I took a ride because I'm stuck in my blue room most of the day working at the computer. And I have tennis elbow now because of the way I hold my arm on my mouse. I've never had that before. But JJ, he goes, excuse me, what's up with your elbow? He said this the other day, and he reached over and grabbed it. And I'm like, ow. And I went in the house. I never noticed it. I knew I had a little pain there, but who cares, right? And I went in the house, looked in the mirror, looked like I had a titty hanging off my elbow. It feels like a titty, too. I got a titty elbow. Oh my God. I'll let you touch it if you want. Come on over. But anyway, I went nostalgic and I just got thinking about this place the past couple days and all the fun we had at this bridge. The Camden people know the Party Bridge. Satchel's Bridge. And I drove in there, and if you don't live around here anymore, I'm going to take you for a little ride with me. Watch this. There it is. Fellers and fellettes. Starting to get a better idea where I am. Here it is. I'm gonna get up here and park and we'll walk over. Here it is, Satchel's Bridge. And normally if it's nice like this and it's a weekend, there's families over here, great little swimming holes in here, nice clean water. Freaking beautiful. One thing I love about this town is all the access to water. It really is beautiful. We had a lot of fun. I think I fished every inch of every piece of creek in this town. But this is the corner where all the Hellraising went down. And one thing I'm going to say, when you come up here to Hellraise, you never ever wore good clothes because of the tire fires. And there was always something weird and green floating in the puddles. And there's a lot of rumors on what that crap was, but we had a lot of fun here, guys. The old Satchel's Bridge. I hope this brings back some memories to some of my classmates and makes you think. But here comes a vehicle. Let's see what it is. All right. All right, guys. There it was. Satchel's. Now I got to get back to work. Later. Boy, I'm telling you. Tire fires. We burnt tires, pallets. Anything we can get our hands on, it was, I know, you shouldn't burn tires. We were dumb kids, idiots, to be honest with you. But I don't think we're hurting the environment at all because although if there was mud puddles up there, they were green. They looked like somebody dumped a glow stick in it. You know, it's toxic. Dumping shit there. I don't know what the hell was going on, but we're up there partying. And I used to wear shitty shirts and shitty shoes because the black smoke for those tires were all over you the next morning. We're breathing that shit in. I can't believe we're even alive. Generation X, we're tough sons of bitches. I'll tell you that right now. We did a lot of crazy shit and survived it. Most of us did anyway. But we had a blast. And before I go in and pick the flavor of the day, I got to talk about Hollywood over here. Channing, AKA Hollywood. This kid is a star. He's going to be a freaking star. I can't explain it. You got to hang out with him to know. He's got all kinds of personality and he's got the looks to go with it. He's talented, smart, and funny as hell. Watch Channing.
Did he really just do that?
Enough,
yeah.
Are you kidding me?
They're missing it.
I can't even.
Oh, you missed it.
Yay, Hollywood. Oh, I hope they don't mute that. We don't get dinged on it because there's a little bit of music. The music's not that loud. And I shortened the video. It was a longer video and I shortened it down. So hopefully they won't ding me on it. But man, where's this kid come up with this shit? I didn't have that confidence when I was his age. I think I was eating paste and picking my ass when I was that age. I was probably one of the dumbest kids on the planet, to be honest with you. Oh my God, I've come a long way. But anyway, guys, heading back. I might come over and get the pugs. I think I'm gonna get the pugs. Heather's working. She had work to do today. Catch up. She was out of town on business. That wind, sorry guys. Let me get under here. Wind action. She was out of town on business for a couple days. Telecommunications conference. And of course she's a little behind on work. So she's trying to catch up and get a head start on the week. The pit boss. Come on, Shay. Come on. The pugs aren't barking, so I'm gonna leave them for now. They're probably sleeping. So I'm gonna go in and pick the flavor of the day. I woke up with this guy in my head this morning. Oh, and I wrote a wicked riff on guitar yesterday. And I have a recorder, and sometimes I record it on my phone. I played it. I didn't record it, and then I can't make it sound the same again. That's why you gotta record the shit. Killer riff. Killer. I mean, it, totally right out of the 80s, guys. I mean, you hear this riff, it's like anything off any of the Rat albums. You know, oh my God, it just gives you goosebumps thinking about it. But I digress. I am gonna go inside, pick the flavor of the day, and enjoy. I don't know what we're doing today as far as food. We don't have much. Grocery shopping tomorrow. But we'll figure something out. But anyway, guys, like I always say, it ain't over yet. Peace.
Door knock in the lead. That's my horse. Man, I don't like these in the lead right now.
Yeah, you can't. Door
knock. He's gonna run out of steam.
Oh, here I am, the anti-aquarian. Where's Rachel? She's not even on there.
Just under 23 seconds
left.
Come on.
What is the goal? Mile? Right together with resilience
who's down on the inside four. Oh, Dornak's fall behind.
Well, yeah, he come out of the gate strong. But listen, he's got, in his third quarter, he should come up, and then in the fourth quarter, crush it.
Oh, Mystic Dan, who's that one? Nobody?
Another five legs, two protected. Sierra Leone is allowed to go moderately at this stage. He has a lot of ground to make up, as usual.
Come on.
They better start cranking.
They're halfway there, more than halfway.
Dornak's coming. He's coming around.
What was he on the outside?
Yeah.
Mind frame is just outside of him. He just got his cue, and he's 3.5 legs.
Put the afterburners.
Oh, and
here he comes. Oh. Is he coming?
Oh, they're almost there.
Go, go, go.
Oh, there comes Mr. Dan. He's calling the hall like a bastard.
Yeah, you got the ones that save and come.
Dornak.
Come on!
Come on, Dornak!
Go, go, go! Yeah, baby!
Who won it? Dornak?
Dornak!
Get out of here!
Corey, need a loan?
Holy shit!
Yeah! Woo! I picked that bitch, didn't
Door
I?
Knocker.
Give me a loan for a couple of. What was his odds?
10-1.
I
like your coach. Your quarterback coach.
Yeah, he good.
You learning?
Yeah.
Listen to him. He's smart.
Yeah.
Fundamentals.
Yeah. Where?
Inside again.